IMAP SMTP email integration. Manage your email in BPM Online with IMAP SMTP email integration. In addition to sending and receiving messages, emails can be automatically connected to system records and used to run business processes. To set up integration with an email service provider in BPM Online, follow these steps. First, register an account in BPM Online from the list of common email service providers. Next, set up mailbox synchronization. If you use an email provider not in the list, you need to pre-configure the connection settings first. Email account setup is performed individually by each user. Let's configure an IMAP SMTP account. Go to the Email tab of the Communication panel, and in the Actions menu, select New Account. The email setup page is also available on the User Profile page. Let's add a new email account. The list displays common service providers with pre-configured connection parameters. If you use one of these email providers, no additional settings are required, and you can proceed to set up your account. If your company uses another provider or a local email server, you must add it to the list of providers and set it up. In the last part of this video, we will explain how to add a new provider. Let's choose Gmail as an example and fill in the authorization fields. Press the Authorize button and save the settings. The settings can be changed at any time. Next, add the email address. It is important to note that Google's security policy often blocks access by third-party applications. If you receive a notification that the username or password is incorrect, follow these steps. First, enable IMAP access in your Gmail account settings and enable access to the account from the outside. Then, confirm the authenticity of the connection by clicking the link in the email sent after the error notification. Setting up the parameters of your Microsoft Exchange account is identical to setting up an IMAP SMTP account. You can learn more about synchronization of contacts, tasks, and meetings in a separate tutorial video. To set up email synchronization, open the account you just created and fill in the parameters for receiving and sending emails. If you want to use the account to send emails from BPM Online, select the Send Messages using the Mailbox checkbox. Select the account as the default account if you want the email address to be in the From field when sending emails. You can give access to other BPM Online users by selecting the Allow Multi-User checkbox. When this checkbox is selected, all users with access can use this mailbox to send email, but not to read incoming emails. For synchronization, the account must be connected directly to the user's profile. Access to email account settings is set up on the email account edit page. Only users who have the right to perform setup synchronization with shared mailboxes and the access to connect shared mailbox operations can grant full access to the email accounts. To enable downloading of emails, select the Download Messages from the Mailbox checkbox. For messages to be downloaded automatically, select the corresponding checkbox and indicate the frequency. Select folders for synchronization and save the settings. Now you can use this mailbox to receive, manage, and send emails in BPM Online. More information about working with emails in BPM Online is available in a separate video tutorial. If your email provider is not in the list of pre-configured email service providers, then you need to set up the provider settings before setting up your email account. Only users who have the right to perform the access to the administration workplace operation can set up provider settings. Let's set up the connection with your email provider via IMAP SMTP protocol. On the Provider Selection page, click the Add Provider button and add the new email provider and specify the type of configuration. In the new window, enter the provider name and specify the email is to be downloaded via IMAP and sent via SMTP. To set up email downloading, follow these steps. First, select the Download Emails Using Protocol checkbox. Select the IMAP protocol. Then, fill in the name or IP address of the incoming mail server, for example, imap.gmail.com. Then, enter the port number for connecting to the IMAP server. If necessary, select the checkboxes that enable you to create a secure connection via SSL or using StartTLS. Specify which data encryption options your email provider supports. If both options are available, for a more secure connection, we recommend using StartTLS. Also, for the protection to work properly, the port must correspond to the encryption protocol. For a secure SSL connection, use port 993. For a connection without encryption or an encrypted connection with the StartTLS extension, use port 143. To configure email sending, perform the following. First, select the Allow Sending Emails checkbox. Then, fill in the name or IP address of the mail server. Enter the port number for connecting to the SMTP server. Specify the email server response waiting time. And if required, select the checkbox to create an encrypted connection over SSL. For the protection to work properly, use SSL port 465. For a connection without encryption, use port 25 or port 587 if port 25 is blocked. Specify the most convenient method of authentication by selecting the appropriate login option. Then save the settings. After configuring the settings, you can move on to registering and setting up your email account, as we described at the beginning of this tutorial.